Hi guys, how are you? I hope you're all having a wonderful day. Do you have difficulty in losing your belly fat? In today's video, I'm going to show you the Ayurvedic recipe that can help you melt your belly fat. Do you know everyone has a different body type, a different metabolism, different lifestyle? But the good news is this Ayurvedic recipe is time-tested remedy. It helps you lose your belly fat, reduce inches around your waist. It helps everyone to lose weight. It is a time-tested natural remedy. It is used in Ayurveda to get rid of stubborn belly fat. This recipe has been around since the ancient times. This is a very traditional recipe. It has a lot of other health benefits too, apart from melting your belly fat. I'll tell you the benefits towards the end of this video. So keep watching to find out how to make this wonderful Ayurvedic remedy. We are going to use 1 cup of ginger, that is about 100 grams. So first I'm going to remove the skin and chop them into pieces. Some people don't remove the skin of ginger before using it in their cooking. The skin has a slight poisonous nature. It gives us indigestion. So always please remove the skin from ginger before using it in your cooking. I'm going to add 1 cup of water to it and blend it. Now let this liquid sit in the bowl. We are going to use only the top filtered water. Actually, if you leave it outside like this for half an hour without touching it, you can see a sediment, white color sediment underneath. We don't want that. We are going to use only the top ginger water. While the ginger juice is settling down, let's get the other ingredients ready. I've got here 5 tablespoons of coriander seeds, and this is 1 tablespoon of black peppercorns, and I've also got 1 tablespoon of jeera or cumin seeds. And this is ajwain, 1 tablespoon. Ajwain is also called as bishop seed or carom seeds. And I've got here is dry ginger, that's also called as sukku. This is, I've got about 2 inches of that. And I've got palm sugar here, that is about 50 grams of pure palm sugar. And I'm also going to use 2 teaspoons of cold pressed sesame oil. In India, this is also called as gingerly oil. I usually buy these good quality ingredients online. If you live in India, you can easily buy them from grocery stores. You go to any grocery stores, you can buy all these ingredients. But it's difficult for me here in the UK. I don't get them in the shops. Sometimes even the Asian stores, I don't find all of them. So I always buy them online. I'll give you the links here in the description box if you want them. I'm going to roast these dry ingredients except the palm sugar in a pan. I'm just dry roasting them. These spices should not be burned, so keep an eye on it. Fry them in low flame. Just for about 2 or 3 minutes should do the trick. You don't have to really roast them. What we are looking for is a nice aroma of the spices. You can smell it while roasting them. Once you get the lovely aroma filling up your kitchen, switch off the flame and transfer it to your plate for them to cool down. Once it cools down, grind it into your powder. If you have one of these powerful blenders, use them, or you can even use your coffee grinder. But make sure the spices are completely cooled down before you grind them. Now keep the spice powder aside while we prepare the ginger. We have already ground up the ginger with water. We are using only the ginger juice from the top. So pour the ginger juice carefully onto the pan. We don't want the white ginger sediment which is at the bottom. Add the palm sugar to this ginger juice and boil it in medium flame for about 5 to 8 minutes. Let the syrup thicken up a bit. The aroma comes out is just awesome. Add the spice powder to this and mix everything together. Add 2 teaspoons of sesame oil. Sesame oil has the property to strengthen our muscles. That's the reason after childbirth, women in India are given traditional meals with sesame oil. Usually women's postpartum body is very weak because of the nutrition loss during delivery. So a lot of sesame oil is used in their postpartum diet. Keep cooking it in low flame until the mixture leaves the sides of the pan. It'll get into a soft jelly kind of substance. Then switch off the flame. It'll thicken when it cools down. When it cools off, you'll be able to roll little balls from it. This is about 1 portion size, that is 1 teaspoon. Eating this 1 teaspoon before breakfast accelerates your fat burning process. It keeps your metabolism really high throughout the day. It makes weight loss very easy. You don't have to starve yourself to lose weight. You can eat all your favorite foods and still you can lose weight by eating 1 teaspoon a day. If you want to see more such weight loss videos, hit the subscribe button as I've got a variety of weight loss recipes in my channel. This Ayurvedic recipe not only just makes you lose stubborn belly fat, but also keeps you away from numerous lifestyle diseases. Excess belly fat is related to so many serious health conditions, including stroke, heart diseases, obesity, diabetes, and even some types of cancers. So eat 1 teaspoon of this Ayurvedic concoction every day and say goodbye to those diseases. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.